Welcome to video classes by Connor Institutes. Today we will be discussing production function. Okay. So before I start production function, let's just brush up what we have discussed in the last class. Okay. So in the last class we were discussing about the introduction of production, producers, and the cost. Right. So this chapter it's all about how the producers are going to produce the commodities. Okay, so in this chapter we will be studying the behavior associated with the producer. So production is a process of transforming the inputs into the outputs, right? So we have seen to buy the raw materials we have to need some cash so that we can overcome those cost of purchasing the raw materials. Yes, so that is also one of the cost which the producer will have to face. So there will be so many costs in the process which a producer will be facing in the process. So from the production, so from the point of from the point of the beginning till the end, the commodity reaches its market, and then whatever the revenue that the producer is getting, these all the things will be considered in under the cost. So how these producers are earning profits is also being discussed in this chapter. So what the producer does here is he tries to invest all the materials, all the raw materials, he pay for all the cost including the labor cost, all the technologies cost, and then once the product is being reached to the market, what happens? Customers come and buy. Yes, so they pay certain amount of money for that, which we call it as a price or MRP, and then they buy. So those all money will be collected as a revenue for the producer. So here what the producer does is he has to ascertain how much he has earned profit, right? So if the costs are less than the revenue, then he is going to fetch a profit. If the costs are more than the revenue, then he is going to be into losses. So these all aspects will be studied in this chapter. So we have seen how inputs have been transformed into outputs. So outputs can be either finished product or can be semi-finished product, right? So I have given example for semi-finished products, how these semi-finished products again are being utilized with the for the other firms also, right? So in this today's class we will be studying this production function. We have studied something similar in the previous chapter called as demand function, right? We have seen there the relationship between two factors, right? So here also in the production function, here also we are seeing the relationship between two factors. So what are these two factors? So when a producer is producing one or the other commodity, he should have land and labor, right? Or land and capital. So these land, labor, capital, raw materials or the machineries, these all are the factors which a producer should have in the production function. So here for a basic, we are considering only two factors, that is the capital and the labor. So without which we cannot be able to produce any of the commodity. So capital is the amount which is being commenced to start a business or to develop a commodity, and labor is the helping factor which helps us to build the commodity, right? So when we are talking about the demand function, it will be Q is equal to K into L. So what is this Q? Q is the quantity produced or the output, what we can say. Then K is nothing but the capital, L is the labor. So the relationship between the capital and the labor tells us how much output we have received, because this is nothing but the inputs, and whatever we have got as the result is the output, right? So here the production functions tells us about the relationship between the capital and the labor. If you have increased any one of these, either the capital or the labor, then you will also get an increase in the output also, right? So it always depends on this. Any number of k or any number of l always gives q. So q is not going to change, but the amount of q or the quantity of q, whatever we are getting from the combination of k and l, will be changed. But we are not going to get 2q or 1q. Q will be always same. So here is an example wherein you can see these are the factors, okay, wherein we have taken capital is nothing but k and the labor is l, okay. So if you don't have capital and if you have labor, then you don't have the output will be zero, right? Because we just have labor and we don't have capital, then how are we going to produce the commodities? We cannot, right? So that's the reason it's a zero, the output is zero. See, in the same way, if we don't have a labor and we have these all the capital, are we going to produce any of the commodities? Again, it's a zero. Why? Because we don't have a labor here. That's the reason here the output is zero. If it has been increased from 0 to 1 and here also from 0 to 1, you can see that here there is one output which we can see from the unit of one labor and with the help of a capital of one unit. Here we are producing one unit of output, right? So in a similar way, if you increase the capital keeping the labor constant, you can see the quantity also has been increased. That's the reason here if k and any of the l have been increased, then q will also increase. So that's the relationship between the capital and the labor. So this q is equal to l into k defines as the production function. We have seen a variety of examples in the last class, right? So for a farmer, what are the necessary factors of production, if we ask? So here the basic factors of production for a farmer will be land and the labor, right? So he should have enough land to cultivate the crops, and he should have some labor so that they can take care of those things, right? So that's the reason if you consider for a farmer, he has to have the capital plus the land plus the labor, right? But now here we'll consider only these two, okay? One is the land and second one is the labor, okay? When we are considering these two, then how we are going to define the production function here? Production function will be, again, q is equal to k into l. Why? Because here for us, it will be l into l, land and the labor. So how he is going to define his quantity or his output? Here, the land, how much land he has. For example, if we say he has only 1 acre of land. So 1 acre of land into number of labors, how many hours they are going to utilize in the work, or how much hours they are going to work in the land is also being calculated. For example, if say 2 hours per day, then this is also considered under labor, and this efficiency of work is being multiplied with the available land resources with the farmer, and then we get the output, which is q. So in such manner we define the production function. So this differs, now we are just talking about the farmer, this may differ from farm to farm or from industry to industry depending upon the factors of production. So when we are talking about the factors of production, I said whatever the factors which are affecting or which are necessary for the production of the commodities are all called as the production factors of a production. So for us here, we have land as a factors of production, we have labor, we have machine, and we have capital. So these are called as the factors of production. So without which we are not able to produce any of the commodities. So here in this chapter, they have given for you to understand only the two factors of production, which is capital and labor. So these are the combinations wherein you can get to know the production function, how it changes with the change in the capital and the labor. So if the capital changes and labor changes, then the Q also changes. So that's all about this production function. If you see this table, we have something called as 10 units here, 10 units here, and 10 units here, right? So we are able to get the output here also 10 with the combination of 1 capital and 4 labor, right? In the similar way, here also we are able to get 10 units of output with a combination of 2 capital, okay? 2 capital and 2 labor. In this also we are able to get 10 units as output with a combination of 4 capital and 1 labor. So, you can see that if you are aiming at certain amount of output, then you can change these capital or the labor, right? So the factors of production can be varied, okay? So this tells about that. You can vary any of these to get these 10. In a similar way, here also we can see 18, here also we can see 18. So these 18 outputs have been achieved from two different combinations of the capital and the labor. So this production function tells us about how the changes happens in the capital and the labor. There will be also a change in the output also. And next we have something called as short run and long run. So what is this short run and long run? Short run is wherein the industries are running for a short period, or wherein it can say only one variable, one factors of production can be varied. So short run is being defined basis on the factors which is being varied. So if the factor, if any of the factor, either the capital or the labor is being varied, keeping constant any one of these. For example, if I have kept capital 4 as fixed and the labor has been changed, then you can see that the whole output has been changed, right? But here what I have kept constant is capital is fixed. So this capital is called as a fixed variable. And the labor is not fixed here because this is a short run, right? So labor is changing according to the situation, what you can say, right? So that's the reason the changing of the factors of production is called as a variable. Okay? Why it is called variable is because we have not kept it constant, we have not fixed it. So that's the reason you can see from 0 it has been increased to 1. But whereas capital is constant here as 4. So depending or seeing on the situation whether either of the factors of production is kept constant or fixed or not is being defined as the short term, short run, okay? In the same way, long run we have. What is this long run? Here we are not defining it on the basis of the days, years, weeks and all. Here we are defining it on the basis of again the factors of production, whether these both the factors of production are fixed or not. So if in the long run, what happens? Either even the capital is also not fixed and the labor is also not fixed. They both are varied. You can see if here also you can have a combination of 3 capital and 3 labor, and if you feel like changing this combination, then what you can do is you can go with the 4 capital and 2 labor. So in the long run, what happens here? The factors of production are not constant. Both the factors of production will be variable. So that's the reason, basis on this, whether the factors of production are fixed or not, we define them as a short run and long run. So I hope you have understood this production function and the short run and long run. In the next class, we will be discussing more on the total product, marginal product, and the average product. See you.